Welcome back guys to the part 2 of electrical machine trainer. In part 1 we have seen the different experiments. If you haven't watched the part 1, you can go to our channel and visit the electrical machine trainer part 1, in which I have explained all the details about this complete trainer, motors, what we are offering with this, and some experiment with the synchronized motor and alternator. In part 2 we will see the basic experiment with the AC-DC universal motor and the three-phase induction motor. We'll try to cover some more experiment in this part and see the difference between all the motors operation and working. So in this part we will start with the universal motor. The universal motor is a series wound DC motor in which we can apply AC voltage or DC voltage, and the universal motor should not be start without any load. So we'll see the working of universal motor with the DC motor at the AC supply, and then we see it on a DC supply as well. First we will start to doing the coupling arrangement in this setup. So here you can see that the motors are right now in decoupled position. We are providing a coupling arrangement with each shaft. This is a trunnion mounted DC motor with speed and load sensor. Load rail is connected over here, so when the motor runs and provide loads on this, you can get the load on the load and torque meter. And the RPM with the proximity sensor you can get on the load and RPM meter. For coupling it with the other motor, we are providing this polypropylene type of material, and it have the slots so that both side of coupling can be connected easily. And for coupling it, you have to just properly align both the motors shaft with each other. Before push it forward, make sure to couple all the slots properly with the both setup, and these two holes for connecting it with the screws. Make sure that your slots are properly adjustable and have a little play. Now I have put the both motors and screw it with these screws. By with this easy method you can easily couple both the motors proper way. If the other one bolt is not properly inserting, just try to pull the motors properly aligned, and then you can easily go through with this bolt. Properly tighten the motors before doing the experiment. So that's how you can couple any of the motor provided with this complete setup. Make sure the coupling is movable properly and motors are completely tightable. So now we'll do the setup for learning the speed torque characteristics of a universal motor working on DC supply. So first we will do the setup of wiring. As given in the user manual, we'll follow the wiring chart for doing the wiring of this universal motor with the DC supply. So for this we'll follow the manual chart, in which the first connections are for single phase AC supply. The T12 T14 terminal will be provided to 3-phase AC measurement panel, so that supply providing to the DC drive panel can be measured. Now output from this T5 will be going to T1. We are using DC drive panel 1. Output of this DC drive panel 1 will be provided to the input on the universal motor. We'll use only variable supply here. So T1, T5 and T6 will be connected to A1 and F1 of the universal motor, and for making armature and field in series, we will connect A2 with the F2 with a short link. So here the wiring for universal motor has been done. Now we move to the DC motor. For this, we will provide supply from T2 of the single phase MCB to DC drive panel T1. Here for motor we are using panel 2. For field excitation, provide field to F1, similarly T4 to F2, T5 to armature A1 and T6 to armature A2 of the DC motor. Now, for measuring the output voltages on DC motor and to apply some load, we will connect extension cables on coil of armature coil of DC motor. And using two more cables, we will provide the output of DC motor, the generated output for measurement, to the DC measurement panel. Another one over here. Now output from the other end from this DC measurement panel will be connected to the load panel. So we'll connect T4 with T18 of the load panel and T3 with T16 of the load panel. Now our wiring is completed. Speed and torque sensor is already connected as per above, and now we are starting the motor. So first, before starting this motor, make sure to turn this load switch at 300 ohm position, because we cannot start universal motor without load. There should be always a load before starting it. Now for starting this motor, we will provide single phase AC power supply over here. You can measure the voltage on 3 phase AC measurement panel and gradually increase the DC drive motor panel 1 potentiometer, and you will observe that motor will start rotating. Observe the RPM on torque and RPM panel. This is right now at 720 RPM. Simultaneously, generated voltage can also be observed on the DC measurement panel. Here right now 75 volt DC is generating, and as I increasing the speed, the voltage generation was also increasing. Now motor is running at maximum RPM. At this position, we can change the load positions at different position and see the variation in RPM also. Right now, motor is running at 1830 RPM. If I decrease the load further, RPM slightly increase, and if I more decrease the load, RPM more increase. And now, RPM in decreasing position as I am increasing the load on the motor. Here voltage generation is also affected because the load is increasing on the motor. Right now load is 1.17 kg and RPM is about 1500. If I decrease the load again, we can see the increment in RPM. So this is how we can work with the universal motor with the DC power supply. With this experiment, we can find out the conclusion that when the load increases, current increases on the motor and speed decreases, and when the load is decreases, speed increases, and with the no load, motor will be at the highest RPM. So heading towards our next experiment. In this experiment, we will see the speed torque characteristics of a capacitor start induction motor. This is a single phase capacitor start capacitor run induction motor. In this, we will see the different characteristics of load and torque, and we will see the starting method in both directions. In a general single phase induction motor, we have a capacitor over here and there are two windings. For this, first winding is known as main winding, another winding is known as auxiliary winding. Both are at the 90 degree phase shift and we use capacitor. First capacitor is used for the starting process for providing the 90 degree phase shift in both the windings. Then the second capacitor is used for running capacitor with the running winding, so that motor can be run with the capacitor and the phase is the in the motor will be continuously induced. The starting capacitor will only be used for the starting of the motor. Now, for wiring up this setup, we will follow the instruction given in the user manual, follow the block diagram, and for understanding the complete schematic and the wiring chart for doing up the wiring with this complete setup. Now, we will start wiring with the low voltage single phase wiring. For this, we have to provide single phase power supply for single phase power supply panel to the 3 phase AC measurement panel for measurement of single phase power supply. For this, we provide supply from single phase AC power supply panel T12 and T14 to T1 and T4 of the 3 phase AC measurement panel 1. Now heading towards the single phase AC induction motor wiring, we'll use 3 phase AC induction 3 phase AC measurement panel T5 T8 to the forward reverse star delta switch for operating the motor in forward and reverse condition. T5 will be going to the T1 and T8 at T2. Now for the output from the forward reverse star delta switch panel, will be directly provided to the motor. T4 is going to the U1 and T5 is going to U2 for the main winding of this single phase induction motor. Now moving towards the circuit of single phase AC induction motor, in which we will assemble the auxiliary winding, main winding with capacitor starting and capacitor run. So we'll connect single phase main winding with the run capacitor C2. Then we'll connect run capacitor to the start capacitor, connecting C2 to C4. Now we'll use auxiliary winding in the picture. For this, we will connect Z1 auxiliary winding with the U1, so that one point of auxiliary winding and main winding will be connected with each other. Now we will connect Z2 with the run capacitor. For this, now Z2 and run capacitor are in series and main winding and auxiliary winding are in parallel. Now we will connect run capacitor C1 with the motor clutch. And completing the setup, or connections with connecting clutch CL2 point with the start capacitor C3. So this is the complete wiring of single phase AC motor. This is for the forward direction. For reverse direction, we will change some connection for forward and reversing the speed motor direction. Now we will move to the DC series shunt motor, separately excited generator winding. For this, we will connect single phase power supply panel MCB2 to the drive motor panel 2. T2 and T4 we can use, or we can use T1 and T3 also. We will connect this to T1 and T2 of the drive motor panel 2. Then T3 and T4 for field excitation will provide directly to the field of DC shunt generator. And now for armature winding of this DC motor, we will connect T5 and T6 to A1 and A2. We will use the extension cord so that we can connect the DC measurement panel for observing the generated output. Now for DC measurement panel, we'll connect A1 and A2 with T1 and T2 of DC measurement panel. For applying some load on DC motor, we will use the resistive load panel as well. For this, T3 and T4, the DC generated output will be connected to T16 and T18 respectively. So our load is connected and speed and torque sensors are already connected as earlier. So here, after checking and verifying all the connections, now we are ready to start this motor. For this, firstly we will turn on the MCB on single phase power supply panel. You can observe there is voltage on the three phase AC measurement panel. The single phase is here right now arise, but motor is not start because we do not turn on the forward reverse start as a switch to the forward position. As I turn this to the forward position, the single phase motor run start in the motor direction and the generator will start generating the DC voltage which can measure on the DC measurement panel. So firstly we will turn on the motor. Here motor is started. Now on the torque RPM panel we will measure the RPM, which is around 29, 10 or 40, and load is about 1.10 kg. We can check the torque as well, 0.98 Nm. Now here you can see the amperes are 0.189 at the first position, because the DC motor should not be started at no load firstly. Now we can turn off the load using the AC resistor panel. For observing the load variation, voltage and current curve on the DC generator, we can use the DC measurement panel over here. Right now you can see the ampere is 0.189 as the load is 750 ohm on the resistive load panel. Also the voltage generated is also showing at the voltmeter. You can check it at the DC measurement panel also, which is 172.4 volts. You can also observe the RPM and load. Right now motor is running at 2910 RPM and load is about 1.04 kg. And torque also can be measured using switch S2, which is about 0.93 Nm. Now I am gradually decreasing the load by resistance load panel. So as I decrease the load to 600 ohm, you can see the current taking by the motor is now slightly increases, which is now 0.235, and RPM and load is also slightly deflected. Again if I increase some more resistance, If I decrease some more resistance load on the motor, it increases, which is 0.46 ampere right now, and voltage is 169. Similarly, on decreasing resistance further, we can get ampere is also increasing, 0.651, and voltage is about 0.67, 1.167 volts. RPMs right now also decrease up to 2880, and load on the motor is increased 1.4. At this point, torque is also 1.28 Newton meter on the torque measurement panel. If I decrease more resistance, the ampere is continuously increasing. You can note down these readings on the observation table given in the user manual. At each step, you can find out the RPMs, current and voltage of the DC generator, load on the DC generator, torque on the DC generator. Now, ampere is 1 ampere. Continuously decreasing the resistance, and this is the maximum position at the load can be provided from this resistive load panel. This is the minimum resistance from this, and we have 1.285 current, and voltage is 159 volts. So we have started from 170 volt, and now we have reached to 159 volts for this. So by using this, you can draw the characteristics of load and torque with the single phase induction motor. Now gradually decrease the load till no load position. At this, you will find the ampere is very minimum or it is zero, because there is no load on the single phase motor, and hence you can find out the maximum RPM on the RPM panel as well. So that's how you can find out the speed torque characteristics of a single phase start capacitor start motor. For stopping the motor, just gradually turn off the forward reverse switch to the off position, and your motor will be stopped. Now for running this motor in the reverse direction, you just need to change the circuit wiring of this single phase induction motor. The capacitor directions, as we can change the capacitor direction by connecting it with the auxiliary and main winding, we can achieve the reverse direction. For this, we'll start connecting U1 with C2. Use the extension patch cords. Here we will connect U1 with C2 and U2 with Z1. Then C2 will be going to C4 for start capacitor, and then we'll connect Z1 with U2, which I have already connected over here. Now we'll connect Z2 with C1, and for providing clutch, we'll connect C1 with CL1, and C3 with CL2. Now, as we can see, the fuel supply provided on the drive panel will be in the forward direction, which supporting the AC motor. If the direction is in reverse direction of the movement of rotation of the single phase motor, the single phase motor will be running in slow speed, because the magnetic field generated in the DC motor will opposes the poles of this motor. For this, for supporting the direction, we just need to change the direction of field excitation also. For this, just interchange the T4 and T3 terminals, and you can achieve this. Now again, I have turned on the main supply, and in this case, first time the motor is running towards my direction, or we can say it is in counterclockwise direction. And if I turn this now, it will run in counterclockwise direction. So direction, you can see, has been now reversed, and it is running towards the front in the clockwise direction. With With this also, you can find out all the characteristics as earlier in the forward direction we have performed. So with this, we conclude our experiment for single phase AC induction motor with capacitor start and capacitor run capacitors. With this, we can find out that the motor which have running capacitor connected permanently has higher efficiency and higher torque for moving the maximum inertia. That's how we can conclude and find out the characteristics of single phase induction motor. Now heading towards our next experiment. In this, we will see the working of 3-phase AC slip ring induction motor. For this, we will see the working of 3-phase slip ring induction motor with star delta starter. For this, we will also use specially designed rotor slip ring panel. With this panel, we can provide different rotor resistances. Also, we can provide the short position on the slip ring rotors. The main advantage of a slip ring induction motor is that in this, a rotor is wound with some external resistance which can create high torque on the low speed. So when the applied resistance on the rotor slip panel is higher, the torque will be higher, and when the resistance are lower, the torque will be lower gradually and speed will be higher. So now let us start wiring up this setup for running the 3-phase AC slip ring induction motor. We'll start with 3-phase dual starter panel. For this, I am using RYB and neutral patch coats for providing the supply from 3-phase input dual starter panel to 3-phase AC measurement panel. So I am connecting RYB and neutral with T1, T2, T3 and T4. All three phases from dual starter panel now reach to 3-phase measurement panel. Now we will use 3-phase star delta panel for running the motor, whether it is in start or in delta. For this, from output from panel 1, measurement panel 1, will provide the output from forward reverse star delta panel at T4, T5 and T6. From here, as we select the forward switch, the phase is directly provided to the second selector switch, and from where we can select whether it is to run in star or in delta position. For this, R, Y and B will be connected to T4, T5 and T6 of the forward reverse selector switch. Then we use another set of RYB patch codes for motor connection in forward reverse and star delta. For this, T7, T8, T9 first star connections will be going to the U1, V1 and W1. Here we will connect them to U1 from R, V1 from Y, and W1 from blue. Similarly, we will take another set of RYB patch code. Now for delta connection, we will connect U2, V2, W2 with the motors U2, V2 and W2 of RYB coil. So these are the motor connection. Now we'll use the slip ring induction motor AC slip ring panel. Now for using the different resistance, rotor resistance on the slip ring panel, we will use R1, Y1 and B1 from this slip ring induction motor to T3, T4 and T5 respectfully. For connecting the different rotor resistances at the starting from the rotor slip ring panel. Now, after verifying all the connections once again from the user manual and wiring chart, now we are ready to start this motor from this following the procedure. Now, first we will turn on the three-phase AC supply over here. Make sure to short the T11, T12 terminal for normal use condition. Now, we will start from the start push button and observe that there are voltages on AC measurement panel. But the motor right now not started because we do not turn any of the switch from forward reverse start delta switch panel. Here line to line voltage is 413 volt and line to neutral voltage is 238 volts. Make sure before starting the motor, your rotor resistance selector switch should be at the short position. At short position, the RPM will be higher. First, we will turn this switch to the forward position and first we will run the motor in star connection. At the star connection, we will see that the motor will not run at the rated RPM. Here motor is started. You can observe the RPM that it is not at the rated speed. Now gradually increase the resistance on the rotor slips. You will find that RPM decreases gradually and torque on the motor increases. Here RPM RPM decreases. The rotor is at 15 ohm position. Now it is at 21 ohm position. We are gradually increasing the resistance on rotor slips. Here RPM slightly more decreasing. This is now at 30 ohm position. RPM more decreasing. And this is at the 50 ohm position, which is the maximum rotor resistance which can provide from this rotor slipping panel. RPM right now very low from the starting stage. Now again we move the selector switch to short position. And we have achieved that RPM right now again at the rated speed. Now turn off the star delta switch to the off position and motor goes off condition. Similar observation can be also done with the delta option. Delta option will provide the phase to phase voltage completely to all the phases and at this time the motor will run at the higher RPMs. Here you can see the RPM are right now, the motor running speed is higher than earlier. Again we will follow the procedure and check the RPM decrement. Right now RPM also not decreasing higher because we are receiving complete phases on all three phases. Here slightly decrement of RPM achieved and current also increasing slightly. You can also observe the current while working with the star connection. Right now we are working with delta connection and observing the current on the motor slightly increasing at increasing the resistance. Here current slightly more increase and this is at the 50 ohm position. The RPMs right now lower and the torque on the motor is higher. Again we will turn the selector switch to short position and we again achieve the RPM. These are rated RPM of this motor. Now we can again off the motor from the star delta switch, again off the forward reverse switch to the off position and turn off the dual starter panel from the stop button. Here now no voltage receiving on the measurement panel and that's how you can do the experiment of this slip ring induction motor. So with this experiment we can conclude that at a star connection the motor will not run at the rated speed because the phases provided or phase voltage provided to the each phase is about 1/√3 of the actual phase. But in the delta connection we are receiving more speed and the higher volume or the torque because the phases provided to the delta connection in all the phases are completely phases providing to the each phase. Also we can observe that the current in delta is higher and current in star will be lower. Now heading towards our next experiment. In this experiment we'll see the speed torque characteristics of a slip ring induction motor with rotor shorted condition and with some different resistances. So wiring up this setup we'll start with 3-phase dual starter panel. We'll connect T2, T4, T6 and T8 for neutral with 3-phase AC measurement panel 1. using arc B, Y and black. We have provided supply to 3-phase AC measurement panel. Now from here, we will forward power supply to forward reverse star delta panel. Similarly, as last practical. Now after that, we'll use T7, T8, T9 of forward reverse star delta switch to motor. W1, V1 and U1. And on the other hand, for delta connections, we will connect T10, T11, T12 with W2, V2 and U2. Now for providing sibling induction and resistance, we will connect R1, Y1 and B1 to T3, T4 and T5. So connection of 3-phase induction motor, slip ring induction motor is done now. Now we are moving to do the connection of DC induction motor. So for using this compound motor as a separately excited DC generator, will provide supply from DC motor drive panel. For this, first we provide the AC supply to the DC motor drive panel. For this we are using MCB2 over here. Connect T1 and T2 . Now for field winding, we'll connect T4 and T3 to F1 and F2. For armature connections, we will use T5, T6 with extension cord so that we can forward the voltage generated to the DC measurement panel 1 and measure the generated output. Now for applying load, we'll use the AC-DC resistive panel from DC measurement panel so that output generated can be directly applied to the load. Use T16 and T18 with T3 and T4 respectively. So here our connections has been now completed. We are now up to running this motor and we'll check the speed torque characteristics of this 3-phase AC slip ring induction motor. For this, firstly we will turn on this power supply, also turn on the MCB on a single phase AC supply panel. Here I will start the dual starter and you can see that voltages line to line 425 and line to neutral 245 voltages and with 50 hertz frequency is showing at 3-phase AC measurement panel, but motor is right now not started. because we do not turn this forward reverse star delta switch to the start position. First we will turn this to forward position so that the output will be on the forward position, and as I turn this to the start position we will see that motor start will running at lower RPM than rated. Here motor has been now started running. We can observe the RPM on the torque and RPM panel also. Now we can observe that RPMs are 1230 RPM right now, and we haven't loaded the generator right yet. So for that we can observe no load over here, and generated voltage is at 78 volts because it is now not running at the rated RPM. We will gradually increase the load and we'll see voltage goes down, load increase on the motor, RPM decreasing. Similarly again voltage is going down. At each and every step we can note down the different resistances. We are increasing the load, increasing the current, RPM going down, load increasing and voltage is going down. We can also observe the generated RPM load on the generator, which is 0.183 now. Here now RPMs are very low. This is 930 RPM for now, and current generated at the load generator is 0.238 amperes. By using these readings you can easily trace the curve on the start running. After decreasing the RPM you can also use the slip ring rotor panel for different rotor resistances. So as we have decreased the resistances, increased the load on the generator, we can now change the rotor position also. Here RPMs are almost very low right now, and when I turn the rotor resistance more the RPM goes more low. Also we can observe the load taken by motor. The current taken by motor is 0.47 right now. With different loading conditions RPM goes more low over here. You can observe it clearly. Now I am again turning it to short position. RPM goes high, and again you can decrease the load from the AC measurement panel and turn off the motor easily. For turning off this motor, just turn this star delta switch to off position, forward reverse to off position, and stop button on the DOL starter. You can observe that there is no voltages generated. Now similar operation can also be done with the delta configuration. For delta configuration we'll again turn this motor to forward position, press DOL start button for first providing the voltages, and now turn this delta star delta switch to delta position. In delta condition the motor will run at the rated RPM. Here you can see the very high RPMs right now. You can observe the RPM on the torque RPM panel, which is around 2640 RPM. Now when we increase the load gradually we can see ampere increasing in the DC measurement panel. Voltage generation is also higher for this case, which is 161 volts DC from the generator side. Similarly we will increase the load on the motor and observe one by one. We can see the load right now 4 kgs and torque is right now 0.93 newton meters. Again I am increasing the load, RPM going 2550, and current on the DC measurement panel is right now 0.793. Current is almost 1 ampere right now. By changing the different load position you can easily find out the characteristics. Similarly now you can change the rotor slip also for different resistances. Now for different rotor resistances, if I increase the rotor resistance, RPM almost go about half, which is around 1590 RPM. And if I again change the rotor position, the slip increases, the RPM also goes low. So that's how we can control the speed also with the rotor slip rings at different positions. You can find out the different voltages and RPM, note down them in observation table, and you can easily find out the speed torque curve of a 3-phase AC slip ring induction motor. So here we conclude our experiment. Before that, turn off the motor carefully by changing this delta switch to off position, forward switch to off position, and press the stop button on the dual starter panel. So with this we can conclude, when the resistance on the motor is lower, the RPM increase and load on the motor increase. In delta position, motor runs on the rated RPM because the voltage provided to each phase is at the actual phase value, and when the motor run in start position, motor will run at the lower than rated RPM because the voltages provided to each phase is 1 by root 3 of the actual phase value. And we can observe that at the different rotor positions and resistance positions, we can gradually decrease the speed by increasing the load on motor. So our part 2 of this electrical machine trainer segment is now completed. For further videos, you can visit our next videos, part 3 and 4 also. And in the part 1, we have explained all the details about this setup completely. You can subscribe our channel and like our videos for this type of content.